Not only are you going to learn why Illustrator swatches are so useful and so powerful, but you're going to learn about them in a real life workflow scenario, because we're going to design a retro poster in today's video. So you're going to need a color scheme that contains 3 or 4 different colors, and one resource to use is Color Hunt. Now do have a browse over the palettes on show, and then simply just click the image button to download your selected color scheme. We are going to utilize this image later in the tutorial to make our swatches within Adobe Illustrator. So now we've finally arrived in Adobe Illustrator, and I've gone ahead and made an A3 print document. And then by pressing I on my keyboard, I can utilize the eyedropper tool to sample this beige color for my background. And the rectangle tool can be used to make the background, and you need to bring it up to the bleed edge. And the shortcut for the rectangle tool is M on your keyboard. So then go ahead and press Command or Control 2 to lock down the rectangle background in place. And you can always use white or any other color for your background. It just depends on your design and also your personal preference. So what is the fuss about Illustrator swatches? They are going to save us a whole lot of time in today's poster design tutorial. And so firstly, go ahead and open up the swatches window. Located in the top right fly down menu, we can create an entire swatch group, to which I'm going to apply a relevant name for today's retro poster design project. Now to add your chosen color palette to this swatch group, use the eyedropper tool to sample a color and then go ahead and make a new swatch. You can then just drag and drop your swatches into the newly created group and do this for your entire color palette. You are soon going to see just how handy using swatches will be for this poster design project. Okay, so now press L for the ellipse tool. And if you do not see these purple or magenta kind of lines on your screen, you might not have the smart guides activated. Now I want to make this circle in the dead center of my canvas. And so the smart guides are going to be useful here. You can toggle them on or off by pressing Command or Control U. But yeah, when you're ready, just hold down both the Alt Option key and Shift at the same time, and then click and drag using the ellipse tool to generate a circle exactly as I'm doing here. The appearance panel is going to be absolutely crucial in today's video, and that is in combination with the swatches. It is really going to perform wonders for us in our Illustrator workflow. So you can go ahead and open up the appearance panel, as well as the stroke panel too. Now we need the circle to start off as a fill, so if you only have a stroke around it, just press Shift and X to flick over to a fill. In the appearance panel, add a new stroke, and this is where having the swatches is really going to help us out here today. Without the swatches, we would have to copy the hex color codes or perform some kind of other long workaround to apply the exact colors to each individual stroke. But we can simply just do that within the appearance panel accessing the swatch colors. Now bump up the stroke weight and apply the colors that you want to use. However, the crucial move that you do need to make is the stroke needs to be orientated on the outside. And you can adjust this by clicking the stroke panel icon here. So now you can go ahead and add a second stroke and increase the stroke weight even more than the first one. It is important to remember to have the larger stroke down below of the thinner one. Now add a third and a final stroke and repeat the same process as before, making sure all of the strokes have the setting of being on the outside. Now you can see how and why the swatches that we made earlier are saving us so much time today. But let's go ahead and finish this retro poster design. Now at the moment, this graphic is a single circle with various different strokes added because we've been using the appearance panel. But we want to expand the design so we have differing vector shapes. Now hold down the Alt or the Option key and then click and drag downwards to duplicate the shape. We want to make sure the last stroke layers overlap perfectly on the two designs. So things are looking very retro indeed, and might I say, also pretty neat. But now let's press M for the rectangle tool and generate a rectangle that matches the exact thickness of the outer circle. Now it's important to use the same color, and you're going to do this for all three stroke layers for the top circle. And when you've done that, it's time to duplicate the three rectangles with the Alt or the Option key. So with the new selection of shapes at the bottom, hold down Shift and rotate them around by 180 degrees exactly. Holding down Shift ensures that they do fix into position exactly 180 degrees. Align it perfectly below to mirror the top graphic, but to add a sense of uniqueness to the poster design, select the circles at the bottom and then bring them to the front of all layers. And so here's the final result that I used and mocked up using a free mockup. You can find the link down below. But today's tutorial was really about the use of swatches and how they save you time in your graphic design workflow. But let me know if you use swatches on a regular basis, and if you don't, are you going to be using them after today's video? Make sure to subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content if you wish to keep learning essential skills about the wonderful world of graphic design. But yeah, until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.